Hi, welcome back down to my basement for another really cool review. Today, from Italy, we have GR Bass and their Cube 800 from their combo range. This cool little and very loud amplifier packs an 800 watt amplifier, which can drive down to a 4 ohm load. We're gonna have a look at that later on. And a whole range of settings across the top. There's a lot to get through, so I'm not gonna waste any time, and let's get on straight to the top panel and we can see what we're dealing with. So, as I said, an 800 watt beast squeezed into a 14 kilo cabinet. This is an easy one-man lift, and we've got this superb handle on top, which means that we're gonna have no problems with schlepping it around. Top panel then, as we come across, we have the power switch on top. Great, where I can see it rather than hiding it around the back. I like that. Top marks straight away. Input jack here. And then next to that, we have an auxiliary in. We've mentioned this in other reviews as well. It's great to see it on this amplifier as well. We can plug in an external MP3 player, a drum machine, or even feed in audio from, you know, a mate playing keyboards or something like that. You can actually share the same amplifier. So auxiliary in here. Moving along then, gain control. This is governing my input level going into the amplifier. And as you will have seen, in the introduction, we have got this row of LEDs. So if I play a nice loud note, I can actually check my input level going into the amplifier, and I've got some really cool colorful lights to tell me what's going on. Now, I'm a sucker for bright lights and switches and buttons and things like that, so I love this already. Now, before we move on, there is a little mode switch here which gives me 4 different options of what these LEDs do as a VU meter, a level meter essentially, or I've got a tuner on board as well, which, hooray, covers 6 string basses. So B, E, A, D, G, and C is also covered with the markings here. So we can tune each of those strings individually. And I'm using, over here, hopefully you can see it on camera, there's a little LED button here which changes the mode. So this display will change to a tuner. One thing I'll notice actually on here already is it's quite difficult to see what some of this lettering is. So you might want to, you know, kind of make sure your head is over the top of the amplifier so you can see what you're dialing in. Okay, so as I said, we're going to zoom through. We've got quite a lot to look at. Next control we have got along, next to our gain control, is we have in here a deep button. So let's listen to this straight away. This is adding in that nice big cabinet sound. In my introduction, I had it switched on. This is what it sounds like off, and I'll switch it back on again so we can compare. So out comes the button. Here we go. Button in. Okay, great. So when engaged, it's that bassy. I can actually feel the stage here vibrate even through this stand. So there's a lot of low ends to be had there. And incidentally, this combo has an external speaker socket as well around the back. And I can imagine if I plugged in a bigger GR bass cabinet, then I could move some serious low end with it just by punching in that button. So really, really nice. Without sounding bloated, that's kind of important for low end for me on bass guitar. I don't want it to be, you know, what people sometimes call pillowy, a little bit out of control. Okay, so moving on from the deep button, we have our normal bass control as we'd expect to find on an amplifier equalizer. This is marked low, and I've got it slightly boosted, but we're not gonna go back to the flat setting. And there's a center click on all of these controls, so you can find where zero is. So I can boost, back to zero click, and then I can cut away. So I can actually take bass away from my signal. This is the flat signal. Cutting away, let's come back just around to about the 9 o'clock setting. As expected, I'm losing the weight out of my bass tone. So unless I really had to, maybe my bass was a quite low, heavy sound, then I'd probably sort of cut some away just to balance it out. But actually with this passive P bass, I'm gonna leave that at least in the zero setting, and as I say, sort of boost it out a little bit just to add a bit more warmth to the sound. Let's go back to where we were. Next control up, we have got two mid-range controls, not just one, which is excellent. I can spread my mid-range breadth a little more. So low mid here, and underneath it, if I just tap my finger on here, there is a three-way switch. This switch allows me to change the center frequency of the low mid control. I'm gonna zoom through these really, really quickly. First of all, I'm gonna boost the low mid up to about three o'clock setting. And at the moment, we are on position A, which is a nice, it's actually leaning into the bass range, about 185 hertz, I think, which is brilliant. That's kind of where I want a low mid control to be, for me personally. Here we go. Now, I'm going to just switch over. I'm going to go to position number two. So listen to that. You can hear that's now not operating on the very low mids. I've come up a little bit. So it works really nicely with this particular bass. Let's switch up to the high setting on the low mid knob. In the studio, that feels a little bit like it's opened the sound up a little bit. Maybe I'll leave it in that setting. Now, not only can I boost those frequencies, I can also cut them. And I'm not gonna go through every single one. Let's just go back to setting B, and I'm gonna just pull that around. I'll go back to the 9 o'clock setting. That's cutting away my low mids. Makes the cabinet sound a little bit bigger than it is by making it sound deeper, more scooped, which is also very, very flexible. I'm gonna go back to the setting that I had before, because I like it. Around we go. And then our next control along, we have the high mid control. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna do exactly the same with this control. There is a three-way switch underneath here. Currently it's in position A, so I'm gonna just boost that up to the 3 o'clock setting, and then we're going to quickly whiz through each of the switch settings. And hopefully, as I always say, if you're listening on decent speakers, so no laptop speakers or earbuds, please, you're going to have to listen to on big speakers or some decent earphones, you should hear the change in character. Okay, here we go then. Nice, there's a bit of a bark going on there. I like that, I can dig in a little bit. Let's move on, position number two. Here we go. Let's move straight on. Position C now, so this is the upper high mids. Mm-hmm. Love it. Yes, that's a really nice setting. So I'm starting to get into that almost slap definition. Let's go and have a listen to that quickly. That's really nice. I can imagine just flicking that switch and getting that kind of sound on stage where it just cuts through distorted guitars, maybe a nice kind of like drum kit, a nice loud drum kit. I like that. Okay, so that is our two mid-band equalizers. Finally, on the right-hand side here, we have a treble control. I have boosted this up a little bit because I like the top-end clarity, and as you can see on the front of the cabinet here, we actually have a tweeter on board, so it's nice to be able to push it and have a bit of brightness out of that as well. Okay, let's push that treble control around a little bit. I'm going to go for the 3 o'clock setting. Actually makes my strings sound a bit newer than they actually are. I like that. It's a nice sort of ringing sound. It sounds more percussive. It's going to be brilliant if you like a bright sound. Maybe you're doing a lot of slap bass and you want that top end zing. If we haven't got enough top end zing though, next to that, we have a bright button, which is going to boost our clarity, our treble, even more. So in it goes. And we'll compare that against what we've just listened to. My bass automatically sounds like an active bass now. It has the extra top end vibe going on. I'm going to back that off a little bit. I think it's bright enough as it is. I'd probably be reaching for my passive tone control on my bass just to pull that back, just to even the sound out. Okay, great stuff. Now, if you found that actually, when I've got my sound, I just want to listen to the bass on its own without that extra color, then right down the middle here, we have essentially a bypass switch. And I flick that on, we get a little LED come on. This is going to bypass all of the EQ color settings. And this is what my bass now sounds like in comparison. Still sounds really nice, but I like all that boost of the extra EQ. I've just been able to sort out my bass tone and make it sound really nice in this room, and I hope that you're hearing the same. Speaking of what you are hearing, we are coming out of the DI on the back of the amplifier. So we have an XLR output, and that's going straight to our recording device. That, of course, could be your output, which goes to your PA system or whatever it might be if you're playing in a bigger band setting. This would make an absolutely excellent monitor behind you and then use a big PA to boost out those thudding lows. Brilliant, brilliant, brilliant. We have in there, on the top here, we have a level control. So you can actually govern the level going out to your PA or recording device rather than being stuck with having to adjust the settings that you just got spot on. Indeed, we actually just tweaked this a little bit going out to our studio setup here to make sure the signal was not overdriving our recording device. And it's over here. So this is our DI level. Next to that, well, we have in tandem with this little dude down here, a little socket, we have a headphone output. So once you've annoyed all of the neighbors with your 800 watt combo, it is that loud, you can plug your earphones in and then go and practice nice and quietly whilst they're hammering on your front door. This also means that if you're using the auxiliary input as well, you can play along to drum tracks, backing tracks and things like that, and really hone your musical skills before you unleash them on the neighbors or indeed your audience. And then finally, we have the master volume over here, the LED button that I mentioned earlier on, which will switch the modes of the LEDs to the tuner, for example. And then the all important, if we have active basses or things that we need to unplug, we don't want any of those bangs and things going on, we can hit a little mute switch here, and the LED, you can see that that's changed to red. The LED is multifunction, so yeah, we've got our little mute here, but also if you start overdriving the input, you may have just seen it flicker whilst I was playing earlier on. This will actually flash red when the input is just a bit on the hot side, and you can wind the gain control down so it doesn't flash. And that'll give you the best signal going into the amplifier. Now going out of the amplifier, around the back we have some really, really useful connections. We have an effects loop, and we can plug in external processors or whatever they might be, and we can put them into our signal path. That sits next to our XLR output, and you could probably use the send from the effects loop as an output as well into maybe another recording device or another amplifier. Things I particularly like about this combo, it has two speak on combo outputs. So at the moment, one is in use for the internal speaker. And then if I, as I said earlier on, if I wanted to plug in another cabinet to move a bit more air, then I have another socket that I can plug into. And as long as this speaker and the one you're plugging into don't go below an impedance of 4 ohms, then you're gonna be absolutely fine. Down at 4 ohms, you're getting the full 800 watts from the amplifier. What I particularly like, and this is, I don't remember the last time I've seen this on a bass amplifier, effects units maybe, this combo has an output to power your pedals. So a 9 volt output at 300 milliamps, that's enough to drive 3 or 4 pedals, I'm sure. So if you've got your favorite pedals, instead of having to, like, you know, scratch around trying to find somewhere to plug those in, a power source, you can use just one of those daisy chain cables and plug straight into the back of the combo and power your pedals just like that. If you're the kind of person who likes to leave a preamp pedal on top of the amp, then this is brilliant. You can take a small cable around from the back here into the pedal, and then you're laughing. You can leave that powered from one box, one cable, one plug, no messing around. Now for the review, you've been listening to the amplifier through the DI output. So I thought what we might do is we're going to pull around a reference microphone, we're going to put it in front of the combo, and we're going to have a quick listen to what the combo sounds like out front. This is going to be important because you kind of want to know what it sounds like if you're going to be using it on stage. So bear with me, I shall pull the microphone around and then we'll do some more playing. Okay, here we go then. So we have microphone of choice, it's an AKG C414. This is a great reference microphone. It's got a nice kind of flat response to it, so I'm hoping that we're going to pick up the entire breadth of the sound. I set the equalizer on the amp kind of where it was before, so you can switch back to earlier on in the review when you can listen to the settings through the DI output and then compare it against the sound that we're picking up here. In the room, it sounds nice and big and full. I'm really hoping that you're going to hear the same. Here we go then. Thank you. There you go, a little bit of a noodle finger style and a bit of slap, so we've got some nice percussive sounds in there, some nice top end brightness. Listen on decent speakers, see what you think. I think this amplifier is actually sounding really, really cool. It's got a lovely natural tone to it, and the actual overall vibe is it's not coloured. So I really feel like I'm listening to the sound of my bass rather than maybe the sound of the speakers, which you get on some sort of vintage coloured amplifiers. Loving the features, loving it's nice and light. I love the pedal power option. That's really, really superb. I think this is going to be one that you've got to go and check out. GR Bass, it's new to me. This is the first time I've had a bit of a play on this brand. I'm really actually looking forward to trying out some of the larger models in the range as well. And they do have quite a range of cabinets, combos and heads. So you'll want to go and check out the website for more information. So there we go. From Italy, GR Bass, loud as you like, the Cube 800. Thanks for checking out the review, and don't forget to read the write-up in the magazine as well, and I'll see you soon.